Dear students, welcome to Geography Unit Number 9, India, Transport and Communication. In this video, let us discuss about the answers for the questions which are given in textbook. After watching this video, click below, you will get the links of previous chapters. Let's begin. First main, fill in the blanks with suitable answers. First one, for the development of villages and agriculture in India, dash means of transport is essential. Answer is road. Second one, the first railway line in India was laid between dash and dash. Answer is Bombay or Mumbai and Thane. Third one, Mumbai port is called as dash. Answer is the gateway of India. Fourth one, Bangalore International Airport is called dash. Answer is Kempegowda International Airport. Fifth one, the newspaper Bombay Samachar was started in dash. Answer is 1822. Let's move to second main. Answer the following after discussing them in groups. First one, define transport and communication. Transport means movement of goods, service and passengers from one place to another. Conveyance of messages from one person to another or from one place to another is called communication. Second question, explain golden quadrilateral and super highways. The Golden Quadrilateral is a project with 4 to 6 lane roads. It was started in 1999. This highway network connects major cities as well as cultural and industrial centers of the country. The superhighways are divided into two divisions. First one, the North-South Corridor, which runs from Srinagar to Kanyakumari. Second one, the East-West Corridor, which runs from Silchar in Assam to Porbandar in Gujarat. Third question, give an account of railways in India. In India, the railways were constructed during the British period for convenient transport of raw materials and the movement of army from one place to another. The first railway line was laid between Bombay and Thane in 1853. Second railway line was laid between Kolkata to Raniganj in the year 1854. third railway line was laid between Chennai to Arakkonam in the year 1864. Then gradually developed in other parts of the country. Railways form the largest public sector undertaking in India. It have a network of about 7,031 stations and a length of 64,015 kilometers. The railways are divided into 17 zones for the purpose of efficient management. Many steps are taken to provide comfortable and safe railway travel. Question number 4. Explain briefly the importance of transport in India. Helps in the development of the primary sector, the secondary sector, and the tertiary sector. Helps to develop resources, agriculture, promotes industrial progress. Widen the market, increases internal and external trade. Provides employment. Air India is India's national flag carrier after merging with Indian Airlines in 2011 and plays a major role in connecting India with the rest of the world. Recently, air transport was in the public sector. But now there are private air transport companies holding permits for non-scheduled services. They are Jet Airways, Sahara Airlines, Paramount Airways, etc. There are 141 airports in India, of which 28 designated international airports, 88 domestic airports and 25 civil enclaves at defense airfields. The Airport Authority of India manages these airports. Sixth and the last question, mention the different types of communication in India. Personal communication. Examples for personal communication are letters or post, telephone, telegram, fax, email, internet, seminar, conference, etc. Second one, mass communication examples are newspaper, radio, television, magazines and books.